Are you looking for an external hard drive that is big enough so it can take up all the footage you take on a shoot and is also fast enough so you can edit right off it? Well, then you will be needing one of these puppies here. What up guys, welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear and today we will talk yet again about storage. So if you're a regular viewer of this channel, you know by now that I reviewed a bunch of Thunderbolt 3 devices in the past. In today's video, I will take a thorough shot on the Samsung X5 external SSD. But this SSD is not just a normal SSD. This tiny little drive here is capable of beating the hard drive within my MacBook Pro late 2016. So this MacBook is equipped with an NVMe SSD. This hard drive here has also an NVMe SSD, but it is faster than the one within the MacBook. And to be honest, I've never ever owned a drive that had such a huge throughput like the Samsung X5. By the way, in the blog post for today's video under eddie-bear.com, you can find a little icon thingy that I made for this hard drive, so it kind of looks a bit nicer and you don't have the stock icon for the hard drive. So what can you expect from the Samsung X5? Well, this hard drive comes in three different sizes. It is available with 500 gigabytes, 1 terabyte, and 2 terabytes. The only things you get within the packaging are the drive itself and a Thunderbolt 3 cable. Other than that, this drive, granted, it has a nice design. I kind of dig the red on the back, but otherwise, it's just a plastic cover. Nothing special here, unlike the lazy drives which have protecting silicone rubber parts on the side, so if you drop these, nothing serious will happen to them. With the Samsung X5, well, this is a hard plastic, so I wouldn't throw it around that much. But the good thing is, it's an SSD, so there are no moving parts in it, meaning if this one is on and you drop it on the floor, well, nothing bad will happen. Unless you eject the drive safely first. Performance-wise, let's start this review with a comparison between the Samsung X5 and my MacBook Pro late 2016's SSD. As you can see here in the benchmark, actually the Samsung X5 is faster than the storage within the MacBook. The Blackmagic speed test is a good indicator on how good such a drive can handle video files. But what about normal files like office files or smaller image files? To see how well the X5 can handle smaller file sizes, I'm using the amorphous disk mark, and even in this benchmark you can see that the X5 is beating the MacBook Pro SSD by a long shot. To see how the Samsung X5 behaves under real-life conditions, I also did some file copy tests and also a video rendering. Starting with the image copy test, which consists of over 20,000 images, adding up to over 30 gigabytes. The whole write test was done within 32 seconds and equaled somewhere around 770 megabytes per second. The read test was done within 54 seconds, so this means the test was almost topping up around 660 megabytes per second. The results show us that these NVMe SSDs have a huge advantage over traditional hard drives when it comes to smaller file sizes. In the video file copy test, we had 41 files, which add up to 120 gigabytes of data. The write test was done in 164 seconds. This means the write speed was somewhere around 740 megabytes per second. At the read speed department, this disk is absolutely insane. So the read test took only 76 seconds and topped off somewhere around 1600 megabytes per second. Overall, these read and write speeds are insane, but we are not done yet. So if you're taking these insane read and write speeds to encode a 13-minute 4K video, it will only take you 14 minutes and 10 seconds with the MacBook I'm having right behind me. But if you throw in an eGPU, then you will actually even save 4 minutes more, So the file will be finished within 10 minutes of encoding. This is insane. So with all these values, what does that actually mean for you? Well, it's easy to say, this hard drive is the fastest available hard drive you can get at the moment in time. There is no faster solution than this one here. The only caveat is you can only achieve such transfer rates with a Thunderbolt 3 device. Meaning if you are having a PC that only has USB-C connections that are USB 3. Something, they will not work. So you will have to make sure that your PC or MacBook has a Thunderbolt 3 connection, otherwise you will not be able to leverage these speeds. Another huge advantage I see here is that you can work with this drive everywhere. It does not matter whether you're in a hotel or at home, this drive will beat pretty much every drive you have, even the ones in your MacBook. So meaning, if you are working from this drive, you pretty much will finish your edits faster and you will be more agile with it. Cause let's face it, I can put this thing right in my pocket and it weighs, I don't know, a few grams. It's not heavy. It's maybe half of the weight of a traditional hard drive. So also no moving parts. If I drop this, no issue. So this is a perfect companion to take along if you're on a shoot, you have to back up your files and maybe edit at the evening event or something like this. For now, this is your best option if you are somebody who works on a mobile environment and needs fast hardware. So what is your opinion about the Samsung X5? Is this a hard drive you may have been looking for? Have you ever encountered a drive that was faster than this one here? Let me know down in the comments below and also make sure to check out my other Thunderbolt 3 storage device reviews. So I will link the playlist up here. And well, with that said, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and do all the stuff that YouTubers do. So I see you in the next one. Peace!